Whether you play the violin, the cello, the viola, or the bass, the bow is actually probably the most challenging part, but also so rewarding because it's what allows you to make that beautiful tone that so many people love and enjoy about playing the instrument. These are some techniques to help you practice getting just the right bow hold so that you can create your best sound. So before I show you the specifics, I want to give you an overarching thought. You want to be relaxed because things that are stiff break. So imagine the difference between dropping a rubber ball on the ground versus dropping a glass vase. The rubber ball just bounces right back up, but the glass vase, it shatters. Why? Because it's rigid. It doesn't flex like the ball does when it hits the ground. So when you are holding your bow, you want to think about a relaxed, flexible hold. You only hold the bow strongly enough that you're not going to drop it. You don't want to clench it. So, a few exercises to help us with that. After you've gotten your correct bow hold, based on the instrument that you play, I want you to try something that I like to call windshield wiper bows. So, standing with your bow horizontal to the floor, you are going to just do this. Rotate your wrist back and forth. Notice that my shoulder is still, my elbow is still. The only thing moving is my wrist. And I balance that bow in my fingers. And as I do this, I can feel the weight of the bow rotate from my index finger to my pinky. So that's what I like to call windshield wiper bow. Next up, having a controlled straight bow is super important. So before we add it to our instrument, I want you to try something I like to call a rocket bow. Again, with your best bow hold, you're now going to go straight up and down. You want to try to keep the tip of your bow and the frog in a straight line. When I do this, I'm still conscious to keep my shoulder relaxed. And finally, one that I like to call bow push-ups. It is especially important that your fingers remain flexible as you play your instrument. So I want you to get your best bow hold, then holding your bow in the middle like this, I want you to extend your fingers and then pull them back up to you. Boing, boing, boing. This helps you get that flexibility in your wrist and your fingers. That's going to give you this effect of the bouncing ball instead of the breaking glass.